Hi guys, let's discuss how Google is tracking its users. So at this point, it's safe to assume that Google knows everything you do online. You know, every website you click or you know you comment on anything, they keep track of. Honestly, Google probably knows more about us than our parents or our friends. Let's see some privacy invasions by Google. Number first, email. Google is well known for scanning the emails you send or receive. Google scans everything in your inbox, from receipt and private messages to medical documents or billing. Number second, location. Google Maps can make driving through unfamiliar areas so much easier. Google tracks and records your every move, including the location data of your photos. That means someone could pinpoint precisely where you were standing, you know, when you took that picture. Number third, everything you search. So Google tracks and records everything you search, including in incognito mode. Number fourth, everything you like. Everything you do is grouped into a personalized profile. All this information is used to show you ads for you and related to your likings and your preferences. Number fifth, what you say in private. If you have a device with Google Assistant enabled, you know, Google may be tracking you. Although there is no proof that smart speaker listen to us 100% of our time, but they are often on longer than they should be. There is a chance they are listening to us. Similarly, even if they are, you know, not checking the data, they are listening in terms of the G word. Whenever you say, you know, hey Google or something like that, they respond. That's not only to devices but also the you know their home Nest system and all that include Google Home, which is the smart home device, and other devices. Number six, Android. Google tracks your search history, your pictures, files on Google Drives, as well as your mobile device location, the ads you view, the video you watch, and more. Everything you do on your Android, Google can track you. Number seven is the YouTube. YouTube is the largest video streaming platform used by almost everyone with internet access. Google can track what you watch, what you like, what you comment on your post. Based on this, Google can identify your interests and likes and show you ads similar to that fashion. Similar with Google Pixel devices and you know their Fitbit watches, because Fitbit is also a part of Google now, so they can track your you know your movements, your heart rates, and other you know information which is really private. There are some ways to protect your privacy for big companies like Google. Number first, stop giving your data. We complain about Google's and other companies, you know, which are tracking us when we voluntarily giving away a lot of personal information. Stop sharing too much personal details online. And also Google settings, you can restrict their ability to track personal activities and location history and such sensitive information if you want to. Number second, find alternatives. I know that this is very difficult to find alternatives, especially the companies like Google, but there are still privacy focused alternatives for you know Google services. For example, if you want to use Google search, try to use Brave Search or DuckDuckGo or something else. Similarly, instead of Google Chrome, you can use Firefox or Brave browser. Similarly, instead of using Gmail, there are Proton Mail, Fastmail, and so on. Instead of using Google Drive, you can use Sync or Ice Drive or something else. Number third, use VPNs. There are many privacy-focused VPNs. There are many like ExpressVPN, Private Internet Access, and so on. They can help us hide from trackers. Please don't use VPN if your country don't allow you to use. Number four, disable ads and data tracking. Most of the personal data collected online isn't for scams or data breaches. It's just for marketing purposes. So with a few simple steps, you can disable many of these trackers on setting pages. Number fifth, unused apps. Remove unused applications and extensions to protect your online privacy overall. And lastly, I need to focus on the settings part. You know, check for the settings where you will find the privacy tab and related option where you can control what Google sees and takes from you as a data. So this need to be done from Google settings. Just go to myaccount.google.com/security, you know, for these type of changes. Similar to you need to do for, you know, other products also, like Android phone, check the settings, go to privacy. Similarly, Google Maps, Google Chrome browser, your Fitbit watch setting, Pixel, if you are using Pixel device, then go to Pixel device settings, Wave app settings, and other apps which you use from Google. Hope this is informative for you. Thank you so very much. Have a nice day. Stay safe online and offline both.